No way. No more pink anything. This is my home.
I own this place as well, you know.
We have to fight this properly, in court if we have to. Not lower ourselves to Claudia's level.
I can't discuss one enough to Botswana.
This could be so good for us, Anna. For all of us.
Are you all right to have Harriet this evening?
Claire, can you go and tell Natalie I'm going to keep him in overnight?
If you want me to go, Rick, just say so.
Oh, dear. I do hope I haven't caused any problems.
I don't think anyone really needs you anymore, Dad.
I had hoped that now you're aware of the little situation that we're in together, you might want to spend some more time with Theo and me.
Claire, I want you to marry me.
Speaking. Oh, hello, Mrs. Green. How nice of you to call.
Where's my PE kit?
Will you excuse me just one moment? Do you have to bellow like some demented hyena? It's in your school bag.
I'm off.
I'm so sorry about that. You were saying. Yeah. Can I stop you right there? No, we're not experiencing financial difficulties. And yes, we did receive the final reminder for Harriet's term fees. But my husband assured me it had already been paid. If you check your school records... Right. I see.
What? What's going on? What time is it?
Tam, you're up. You're supposed to be in surgery in less than an hour.
Oh, Lord. Oh, I can't. My head's banging.
Yeah, well, I'm not surprised with the amount you put back last night.
Was that all me?
Right. I'm not prepared to put up with this a minute longer. I only got 3 hours sleep last night, thanks to you. You come home at all hours, music blasting out. This is not a DOS house. Now, get your clothes, I want you out of here.
Where am I supposed to go?
Not my problem.
So I take it she didn't ring last night?
No. That's 3 days now. And she's been avoiding me at work, so it's pretty obvious what the answer is.
Wouldn't she just tell you? It's not like Claire to mess someone about.
Maybe she can't face telling me. I've acted like such a prat lately.
Come on.
It's true, though. Been like some jealous adolescent. God knows why. Even with the likes of Matt. So not me.
Yeah, well, we've all been there.
I'm sorry. Here's me moaning on feeling sorry for myself and you're in an even worse predicament than me.
Hey, not for much longer with a bit of luck.
Really?
Yeah. It's like Anna and I are getting somewhere at last.
Yeah, that's fantastic.
Fingers crossed. Kind of connected the other day. You know, with the Lion Cup of all things. Just for a minute, it was like it used to be. Life before Fiona Jones got her claws in.
At least you've got somebody to blame. I've got nobody but myself.
So how long haven't you seen him for?
Must be best part of 5 years.
That's weird.
Hmm.
How come you weren't in touch?
It was my fault. You tried to, but, it's a long story.
Sorry I slept in.
Are you feeling any better?
Much.
I've got to go to work soon, though.
Oh, yeah, but, help yourself to whatever you want. Make yourself at home.
Cheers. What time do you finish?
6 o'clock, but I could take a lunch if you want to meet up.
That'd be great.
I'll leave my key.
OK. Thanks. It's so lovely to see you, Chandra.
I've missed you so much.
Been at wholesaler since crack of dawn. Just go straight up.
What'll I do if she says no?
I don't know, mate. You can never second guess a woman, but my money's on her saying yes.
Oh, God, I hope you're right. I'd never tell her this, but I wouldn't have left Deborah if it wasn't for her.
I know.
I gave up my home, everything I've ever owned. I'd have absolutely nothing.
Hey, come on, mate. Stop being so negative. This isn't like you. Drink the water. Well, I guess you're not in surgery today.
I'll be all right.
Yeah, but we'll squirt at a cocker spaniel. You'll still have all his bits left when you're finished. You go and get in the shower. I'm going to ring in work. Tell him you're sick.
Cheers, mate. I owe you.
Richard?
Oh, great.
Could I speak to my husband, please?
Sorry, Deborah, he's not here. He's gone to the doctor's.
Richard?
Yeah, he's been up all night. Headaches and night sweats.
In the 16 years of married life we've shared, I've known Richard visit the doctor once, when he had a bout of irritable bowel syndrome.
Right. Well, that just goes to show how bad he feels.
And do you know if he intends coming into work?
Not sure. Have you tried ringing him?
I'm not stupid. He doesn't answer my calls.
Right.
Tell him Mrs. Green's been on the phone and she's furious.
Mrs. Green?
It's extremely urgent.
Well, as soon as I set eyes on him.
Harriet's head teacher. Haven't paid last term's fees.
Look, mate, I'd help you out if I had any.
It's okay. I have to go to the bank later. Try and sweet talk the manager.
Well, you can look on the bright side. If Claire says no, you can always pawn the ring.
That is so not funny.
Sorry, mate, I couldn't resist. Go and get in the shower.
Taking over the whole house, and I can't cope.
Okay.
It's all right for you. You're not having to live with it. Stop it, you two.
Well, I did say right from
Lee
the very beginning...
Lee's around till 3 o'clock in the morning playing loud music, and Claudia and her sister have set up some pet shampoo service in our bathroom.
What? That's ridiculous.
The children had to get washed in the staff toilet this morning. I can't carry on like this.
Like what?
We're going to have to set some rules around here, Claudia. You are taking over this whole house and it's not on.
I fell asleep
and you
left
and your family
my music
are going to have to leave, or we are.
No, you're not going anywhere. This is your home.
It's ours and all. Then why don't you wash up every once in a while? Or put some washing in? Or flick a dust around the house? I've asked you 1,000 times to try and keep the noise down and not leave your clothes in the middle of the floor and your empty cans all over the house. What kind of example are you setting to my children?
They love our Liam.
My point exactly. I am trying to bring up a family in this house. And I've got a professional job to do.
And so have we.
You can hardly compare a beauty therapist with being a vet.
Well, I don't see why not. One's with humans and one's with animals. I mean, that's the only difference.
Oh, it's no good. You might as well save your breath.
Look, I think it's just best all round if your brother and sister leave.
What? Sorry, no can do.
Well, you haven't got a choice in the matter. You can stay, but they're going tomorrow morning.
We'll see about that.
I'm not asking you, Claudie. I'm telling you.
Really? And what are you going to do about it if they don't go?
We'll find a way to move them out. We'll take you to court if we have to.
You'll take me to court?
That's a laugh. What's that supposed to mean?
You'll see.
Have you changed the barrel, love?
No, I'm cleaning glasses, like you said.
OK, I was only asking.
Morning.
Morning.
Here, have you got a couple of minutes?
I can't, I'm running late.
Well, it's just... It's Theo's show and tell at nursery today and, well, I was wondering if you'd like to come.
I can't, I'm working.
Yeah, well, so am I, but I've asked my dad for the time off.
Oh, is he? Rick's hungover and they're going to be a vet down.
Well, that's their problem, isn't it?
Fiona, I couldn't come anyway. Jake will be there.
Well, maybe it's time you told Jake he's got another brother.
Look, I've got to go, but we'll speak about this later.
No. We'll speak about it now. I want you at his show and tell. I mean it.
You're threatening me?
It's just, I want everything to be out in the open. I want us to be a proper family, like you said.
Just give it time.
I've given it time, and I'm sick of waiting. Not either you start telling people, or I will. I'm not going to be mucked around any longer.
Look, I'll see what I can do. And I'll call you, right?
You don't need to call. Just be there at nursery at 12.
Has everybody got the clickers?
I've got mine.
Good. Well, Jane should be here any minute now, and then we'll start session 2. Have you all been doing your behaviour homework?
Twice a day.
Oh, well done. So, session 2, we'll be building on what we did last week. And we might even get your puppies to sit, if we're lucky.
I just want him to stop chewing the chair legs.
I'm sure Jane will have some good advice.
In my day, dogs were dogs. He fed them and put them in the garden. If they fouled in the house or did anything wrong, you wrap them on the nose with a rolled-up newspaper.
Yeah, well, we used to beat the rugs on the line and put the washing in the mangle. But time's moved on, Deborah. And anyway, we charge £200 for a puppy training course, so we're all quids in. She shouldn't be too long now. I tell you what, you can be reading the leaflet for week 2.
Do you know how much longer it's going to be? Henry's getting himself in a tizz with all these puppies yapping.
I know exactly how he feels, but I'm afraid I can't say. We're waiting for the vets and the behaviourists to appear, and unfortunately, I don't have a magic wand.
Sorry I'm late.
Ah. Did you pass my message on to Richard?
Yeah, he's going to ring you. Look, I don't want anything scheduled in over that lunch break. I've got to go somewhere.
I'll see what I can do.
Who's first in surgery?
Cocker spaniel castration.
Oh, he's a bit peaky this morning. Dry nose, isn't it? I think you should give him a look over before we prep.
OK.
Well, that's very inconvenient. Everybody's sat here waiting. You could have told us earlier. Well, I'll see what we can do. Thank you. Apparently, our animal behaviourist has been involved in an accident and has been taken to hospital.
Oh, you're joking.
I had to cancel my driving lesson to come here today.
Can't you do it?
Well, I don't know what to do.
Well, read the leaflet. How difficult can it be?
Good boy. Hiya.
Morning.
I'm supposed to be doing a castration on this fella today. What do you think?
He doesn't look too bright, does he?
Are you all right?
Yeah. I'm just shattered, that's all. Had a bad night's sleep.
She teething again?
No. Liam brought his mates back and played music all night. I'm getting really fed up with it.
Yeah, I'm not surprised.
I've got a full day today as well. I've got consultations all morning, then I've got Jake's show and tell, and then a PD up at the Farabees. I feel like I'm being pulled in every direction.
Well, look, I could do the Farabee testing if you like, and if it comes to that, I could do Jake's show and tell as well. You could get your head down this afternoon.
Well, you've got surgery all day.
Well, I could ask Sarah to take over.
No, I can't let you do that.
Anna, I'm the father.
Yes, I know. And you're going away. How the hell am I going to manage without you?
Well, you don't have to manage without me. You can come with me to Africa. We can be a proper family again out there. We can put everything behind us and start again. I mean, come on, the kids would love it. You love it, you know you would.
I've told you, it's impossible.
What's impossible? All you have to do is say yes and we'll make the rest happen. It'd be giving us a chance away from everything that reminds us of the past. It'd be just us. Our family. Nothing else really matters, does it?
Well, what if I get out there and I can't forget? I mean,
it's not
a
question of forgetting, Anna. It's whether or not you can forgive.
You know it's more complicated than that.
Why does it have to be? What else is there to think about?
I can't just up and leave. I've got responsibilities.
Yeah, to who? To Matt?
No. Matt has got nothing to do with this. What about Sarah? What about the practice?
I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to upset you. I'll do the Farabee PD and I'll do Jake's show and tell.
Thank you.
Jimmy keeps chewing my hand all the time. What do I do about that?
Oh, they call that mouthing. It'll stop in time.
And what about him pooing all over my John Lewis rug?
Oh, well, yes, well, I think that that might be week three. But today we're going to do command and reward work. Right, so, if you'd like to take the leads off...
Oh. Are you sure?
No, then, that's what it says. That's it. Oh, Eck. Sorry. Take the lead and put it on. Sorry, can you get them back?
Jimmy!
Stanley!
It's not that I'm deliberately avoiding him. It's just with Deborah's scheduling, I never get to see him.
Oh, come on, pick up the phone, speak to the man. He's going demented.
What do you mean?
Well, he's drinking too much for a start. He isn't at the doctor's. He's at home. He couldn't have operated today.
Oh, my God, I don't believe this.
Just give him a ring. Let him off the hook one way or the other.
It's not as simple as that.
He asked you to marry him. Just tell him yes or no. Could you pass the suture material? You owe him that, at least.
What does that mean? What has he been telling you?
Nothing. But he walked away from a lot for you.
I didn't ask him to do that.
I know, but he did. And he's in a pretty bad way.
I want to give him an answer. I want to say yes, but I just can't.
You know you're just like Anna. Always making a problem where there isn't one.
You don't know anything about my life, Tom. You've no idea how complicated it is.
You know, we've all got complications, Claire. Each and every one of us.
There's a little feather loss, but no serious damage.
It's the next they go for. You should see him. And all over one little female turkey. Same one every time.
Yeah, there's some fresh pecking scars here at the base. Have you got some separate pen areas for them, Mr. Hoskins?
No, I just let them roam about, like nature intended.
Oh, well, unfortunately, sometimes nature intends the survival of the fittest. One rival has to win over the other. Anyway, we'll clean up his wounds and give him a dose of antibiotic just in case of infection and then bind his neck.
He's scarred by love, the poor fella.
And you might want to think about setting a separate area for them, for the bird's own good.
Mm-hmm.
much it costs. I want him here today. Well, I won't be paying his last bill unless he shuts... Shut up, will you? Can't hear myself think. Yeah, all right. I'll leave it with you. Ta-ra. I'll teach him to mess with me and my family.
Have you gone undone now, Claudie?
You find out soon enough.
Feeling you're not very happy with me.
No, just got a lot on my mind.
Not me, though.
What?
It's not me that's on your mind.
Look, Matt, I'm sorry, but today is not a good day to talk about us.
All right, I get the message. You just need to let me know when is a good day.
Yes. Okay.
We could go out one night next week if you want.
Who? You and me, or you, me and my four kids? That'd be fun, wouldn't
it? No need to be like
that.
Don't
you think I'd love to go out at the drop of a hat? Make decisions based entirely on what I want, just for me. It might be that simple for you,
but... Hang on a minute. I made a pretty big decision based on you.
I didn't ask you to give up your music. In fact, I
wouldn't
have told
you
quite right
to go. Yeah, I could be your shoulder to cry on then, a distraction to take your mind off things.
It wasn't like that.
Oh, yes, it was, Anna. Face up to it.
No, you're wrong.
Right, I'll tell you what, I'm going to make this really simple for you. I'm not going to ask you anymore. If you want to spend time with me, just let me know. Are we done here?
Yes.
Right.
Look, Matt...
Doesn't matter.
I didn't mean to be
Forget so... about it.
We've got a meeting today at 12 o'clock.
What kind of meeting?
Well, it was you that said that something had to be done, so I've done it. It's all set up, midday in the living room.
Anything else?
Sarah, you wanted today, living room, 12 o'clock.
Why, what for?
Medication, that's what Miss Lister calls it.
What are you talking about?
I'm talking about you get your fella around here and I get mine and we get this thing sorted.
Ridiculous.
But we've got clients to see.
Well, cancel them.
Well, just tell your brother to find a new place and then that's an end to it.
I'll hear him, he's staying right where he is. And if you won't take it from me, you'll have to take it from my solicitor. Hi, love, our Paula's ready for you now, love. You've got to bite down on this, won't wax rips off.
Thank you very much. Okay. Excuse me, those rubber bones are £5.20.
All right, put it on slate. Follow me.
I could swim for it. I'll ring Peter Clancy.
Deborah, we're going to have to rearrange all this afternoon's appointments.
What?
I'll see what I can do. How nice of you to return my calls.
Sorry.
Did Tom pass on my message?
Yeah, but I was,
What?
Busy.
I hope you were busy sorting out our daughter's school fees, because Mrs. Green rang this morning.
It's sorted.
That's what you said last time.
I thought it had been paid, but the transaction didn't go through. It's not easy keeping two homes going, Deborah.
Don't you dare talk to me about your difficulties. How about Harriet? How difficult do you think it is for her when the girls at school make fun of her because of your inadequacies?
It was an innocent mistake, OK?
I hope so, Richard. Because there's a school skiing trip to Austria this winter. It's expensive, but I told her I was sure you wouldn't want her to be the only girl not going.
Fine, just let me know how much it is.
And what did Dr. Roberts say?
Dr. Roberts?
Oh, I'm sorry. I thought you had an appointment this morning, but I must have got it wrong.
OK, if you could clip Shane up for his ultrasound. I've got a Farraby visit and then I'm off to Jake's nursery, but I should be...
Hi, I was just wondering if it were possible to have a quick word with Claire.
I was going to ring you.
But you didn't.
We've had back-to-back ops all morning, but we're nearly finished here.
I just wanted to know if you'd meet me for lunch.
I can't, not today. I've already promised to meet somebody.
Who?
A friend.
I'll take Cleo through to the kennel.
No, it's OK. I'll do it.
OK, but could you tell the owner we need to keep her in overnight?
Sure.
Leave it, Rick.
I can't.
Next week. I arranged it.
I need to talk to
you. Everyone needs to notify the clients.
Just tell me who you're meeting.
I'm sure Richard can take your appointment, seeing as he's made such a miraculous recovery.
I'm taking the day off, actually.
Well, it's inconvenient.
Tough.
Rick, leave it.
What's the matter? Too busy running after little Miss Homewrecker like some naughty puppy dog?
Why do you have to be like that, Deborah?
Rick, not now, please.
You really are a poor, deluded fool. Can't you see she doesn't give a damn about you? All she can think about is how to let you down.
That's not true.
Well, what do you keep running away from him for?
I'm not.
A 43-year-old lovesick puppy, how sad. She's probably got someone else lined up already. Perhaps someone else's husband this time.
You are sick.
She's had her fun. She's wrecked your family and your life, and now she wants out.
Tell me she's wrong.
Do you really think I'm like that?
I don't know. I've asked you to marry me. You haven't given me an answer yet.
Because it's complicated.
It's not complicated, Richard. It's really very simple. You're no use to her. You're no use to your family. You're no use to anyone.
How can you say things like that? Can't you see how hurt he is?
We had a perfectly happy life till you came along. You're not the only one who's hurting, Richard.
You know, when I walked into reception a few minutes ago, I was feeling pretty good about myself.
How can you feel good about yourself? You've got a daughter who's pining for you. You can't afford to pay her school fees, and the harlot you left her for won't commit to you. I'd say life was pretty grim.
If you haven't got anything good to say, I suggest you keep your bitter, twisted mouth shut.
Look, can we just stop this now, please?
How dare you speak to me like that?
I'll speak to you any way I like. All this time, I've watched you beating up on the nicest, kindest man I've ever known.
Nicest, kindest man? You sound like you're talking about your elderly next-door neighbour, not someone you're in love with.
But what would you know about love?
More than you think.
You don't give a damn about Rick's feelings.
And you do.
Let's just call the truth.
And for the record, I didn't take him away from you. You drove him away and you know it, and that's what's eating you up.
Claire, don't give her what she wants.
You're poisoned, you know that? Poison. No wonder William Montgomery wouldn't touch you with a 10-foot barge pole.
Right, that's enough. As practice liaison manager, I can see this has become an untenable situation, and therefore you leave me no alternative but to let you go.
What? Deborah!
You're fired.
Deborah, don't
be
ridiculous.
You can't fire me.
I most certainly can fire you.
Can she do that?
No.
No.
Well, strictly speaking... Well, let's put it like this. Either she goes or I do. You choose.
Now?
Yes, now.
Hannah?
I'm sorry, it's not just down to me.
I'll manage without Deborah.
It's all right. I'll go.
No, this is ridiculous. Can we just... talk about this?
There's nothing to talk about. I've made my mind up.
Rick?
She's always going to win, isn't she?
Claire, please.
Leave me alone. Stay away from me. I never want to see you again.
Claire!
Please don't waste your breath trying to get me to reconsider. Now, where were we with these client cancellations?
Claire!
Leave me alone!
Please, just let me explain!
What's to explain? Your wife just fired me a new letter!
What can I do? It isn't my practice. I thought Anna or Sarah would have said something.
You should have said something!
Like what?
Like if I left, you'd leave.
Claire!
Is everything all right?
Fine! I can't afford to leave, Claire. I'm overdrawn at the bank. I've had to take a loan out on the house to pay for the school fees.
It's not about money, Rick. I don't care about money. I just needed you to be there for me.
And I needed an answer. Oh. Claire, I didn't mean that.
Well, if what Deborah says is right and the situation has become untenable, then we have to get a new nurse. We're down to Matt and Margaret now.
And I don't know how long Matt's going to be with us.
Why?
I don't know.
Why, what have you done?
I suppose I'm messing him about. He's getting fed up. I don't know what to do.
Come here.
Tom's talking about leaving.
Where's he going to go?
Botswana. He's been offered the job at a big game reserve.
Right. When's that going to happen?
A couple of weeks. He wants me and the kids to go with him.
Well, you're not going to go, are you?
If I don't go, the kids won't see the dad. And if I do go, I feel like I'll be letting you and
Matt and everyone at the practice down.
Hang on. Take me and the practice out of the equation for the moment.
I really like Matt. And I do feel something for him. He's exciting and sensitive, and he makes me feel good about myself.
Do you love him?
Dunno. Yeah. I think so. But not like I love Tom. No matter what he's done, he's my soulmate. I'll never love anyone like I love him.
Oh, sorry, I hope I'm not interrupting anything.
No, come in.
Thanks for coming at such short notice, Peter.
Bought all the relevant paperwork, so...
I think this is going to be the most ridiculous waste of time.
Well, not necessarily, if we want to get everything sorted out. Has your stepmother's solicitor arrived?
I've no idea, they're through there.
Right, well, shall we join them?
If we must.
Let's get this over with.
Okay, two more minutes and we'll start. Now, who wants to go first? Jake, do you want to go first? Come sit here.
Daddy.
Hiya.
Daddy!
And who do we have here then?
A lion cub.
Sorry. Lion cub. Have you been?
I thought you weren't gonna make it.
I got stuck up at Farabee's. You know where Yatta's
so
on.
Did Daddy help him get better?
Yeah, my daddy made his leg better.
Did he?
How come Anna isn't here?
She couldn't make it.
And he stayed with you for the whole...
Did you put her off?
No, she had some sort of family meeting.
Did he? If it's family, why aren't you there?
Well, I'm not family anymore, am I? Not as far as Anna's concerned.
A week.
And what do you call this lion?
Simba.
Simba.
Does she know you're here for Theo as well as Jake?
It's none of her business,
is
it?
What's your favourite things about lions?
Yeah, but... I think she should know, I mean...
Yeah, what else?
If we're going to be open and above board about it all...
Let's just take this one step at a time.
Can you do that noise?
I'm here, aren't I? We're both here for our son.
That's good, isn't it? Let's all give Jake a big clap for telling us about the lion cub.
Brilliant! I am so sorry. Never rely on the bloody sat-nav. Hubert Bryce-Jones, this is my pupil, Eric Chone. Hello, Peter. Long time no see.
Not since you moved in with the big boys.
Do you know him?
He's a top QC on inheritance law.
Paid for by our dad's life insurance, no doubt.
Mrs. Williams. Lovely old house, this. Victorian, is it?
Yorkshire stone, I think.
Oh, smashing. Right. Shall we start? I gather you two are the daughters.
Yes.
Anna Williams. Hmm.
Right, well, it's perfectly straightforward in my view. My client, Mrs. Claudia Williams, is the sole owner of the contents of this house.
No way.
You must be kidding, right?
I did try and tell you that.
But half the stuff in this house is mine, bought and paid for by me and my husband.
Do you have receipts?
I mean, bought over years and years.
Now, without receipts, everything automatically goes to Mr. Williams' wife.
I don't believe this.
If we might move on to the issue of the house itself.
Yes, we had three independent valuations, and it's worth between £950,000 to £1 million.
Hmm. Well, we'll go with the nice round figure of £1 million.
Oh, they're nice.
Take away the sum of £125,000 due to Mrs. Williams from her late husband's estate.
Why did she do that?
Because that's the law. Leaving the sum of £875,000, half of which comes to £437,500, precisely. That's what's due to you, and that's what's due to you between you both if you sold the house tomorrow. And that's really all there is to it.
I'm sorry. There's no way on God's earth that we're going to accept that without a bloody good fight.
Mm. And then the only people to benefit will be the lawyers, and believe you me, you'll end up with nothing.
I don't live here. I live with my husband. But this is Anna and her children's home.
It's my home too.
She gave up her home to come and live here and look after Dad and the practice when our mother died.
I gave up a bloody good job at the post office to marry him.
Oh.
All I was trying to do was to stick up for you. Because I'm sick of hearing her talking to you like a dog. In fact, I wouldn't talk to a dog like she talks to you.
I appreciate you were trying to defend me, but
you
it's not...
let her walk all over me, just like she walks all over you.
Deborah, please, I don't care about Deborah. All I care about is you.
Well, you could have fooled me.
I'll leave the chase with you if that's what you want.
It was a bit late saying that now.
Claire.
Let go of me.
Just listen to me.
I won't be let down like that. I won't.
Look, if you can't have lunch with me, why don't we meet up this evening? I'll cut you something round at mine and we can talk about...
Hey, you're back early.
You talk about me letting you down.
Oh, how did I know you'd react like that?
It was right.
Rick, will you just listen?
I've just been making a fool of myself. I couldn't see what was staring me in the face. I can't do this anymore, Claire. I really can't.
Fine. Okay. Go.
I take it that was Rick.
How did you guess?
Have you been to the pantomime? And who did you go to the pantomime with? Aren't you going to tell us? Well, we'd like to know, wouldn't we, children?
Yeah!
Tell him, Theo!
Are you going to tell us who you went to the pantomime with?
He's got no confidence.
He's just a bit shy, that's all.
Was it Mummy?
Sure as hell wasn't Daddy, was it?
Never mind. Next time, Theo, you go sit back down. Right, who's next? Kieran.
You know, it might help. Had someone other than me to talk to once in a while.
All kids go through a phase.
It's time you told him you're his dad.
Yeah, maybe you're right, but I've got to tell my children first.
He is your child. And it's about time you knew I am sick of him and me always coming second. It's like he's frightened of her.
Maybe he is.
Yeah, but with me, he's completely different. If he doesn't like anything, he just says it. Like him thinking you were my lover or something.
He didn't exactly let him off the hook. He could have introduced me properly.
He didn't give me a chance.
Chandra.
Yeah, well, it serves him right for not sticking up for me. And to top it all, I've lost my job now.
So come home.
Oh, come on. Tell me what you found out about today, then.
But just so we're all singing off the same hymn sheet... Everything in this house belongs to me. I can flog it, chuck it, I'll keep it, right? So what about windows?
No.
Because I want that big old drafty window on the stairs changing to double glazed UPVC.
Not while I breathe. Can we just stop a minute? I want you to watch something.
I know it's very difficult to get you to come back home, but I'm hoping to tempt you with a bit of sunshine in Malta. Oh. Well, I know it's secret.
You look like Dolly Parton's younger sister. And you're going to be Kenny Rogers.
I've done my stint. So it's over to you, Turner.
Which team?
Well, you will say that. I'm giving you the house and the practice, the lot. Because I've got what I want.
I don't want it. I've got a job.
I don't think you could have said it any clearer.
Lovely as it is for you to have your family memories, I'm afraid the video has no legal value.
But they were going to go live in Malta.
Not living. We were going on an extended holiday for a couple of months. I got us this fantastic pensioners deal.
You heard what he said. He wanted to retire.
Yeah, but he changed his mind, didn't he? That's why he had his passport.
He didn't tell me that.
But it turns out he were only going to Malta for me. Bless his little cotton socks. He didn't want to go. Not really. But he would have got me the moon if he could. Because he was such a gorgeous man. What?
Give me strength.
Sanjay says the last he heard was that Raj came back to England and was living in Wolverhampton. So I've emailed Mina, and I'm just waiting for her to email me back.
Can't believe he's been in Wolverhampton and he hasn't been in touch.
He probably thought you wouldn't want to hear from him. And anyway, how could he when no one knew where you were?
It's easy enough to find someone if you really want to.
We tried to find you, believe me.
Mama G was so upset she was inconsolable. I don't think she ever really got over you leaving like that.
Yeah, well, she should have stood up to Dad.
Can I tell them you're okay?
Hang on to that thought.
I just wanted you to have this because I've behaved appallingly towards you.
Yes, you have.
I'm so sorry. I hope he makes you happy, Claire. I really do. You deserve it.
He's my brother.
What do you say?
I'm Chandra's brother.
Chandra?
That's my real name.
Chandra, right. You're a brother. Hmm. That is fantastic news. That is the best news ever. Bloody brilliant. That means it's your family.
Yes.
Pleased to meet you, mate. Pleased to meet you. You're meeting him for lunch. Oh, I'm such an idiot.
Now, if this does go to court, we will without a doubt be dealing with the issue of dependency. Now, the only true dependent of the late Mr. Williams in this room is my client, Mrs. Claudia Williams.
Yeah, that's right.
I beg to differ.
Surely any judge would take into consideration the sacrifices that his eldest daughter's made to look after him and run the practice.
And that she and her father's grandchildren still live in this house.
Hmm, true.
Well, what's that got to do with it? You said the law's the law.
I think a judge would be minded as to the length of the deceased's new marriage.
Yeah, all of 2 minutes. It doesn't matter how long. It's how happy I made him that counts.
Nobody's saying that you didn't make him happy. We're just saying that you were only married to him for a very short time.
So, what she's trying to say is that our dad wouldn't know a grubby little gold digger if she had it tattooed on her forehead.
You think you can talk to me like that?
Yeah.
And go banging on about everything Joan of Arc's given up for him when she's not even his proper blood daughter?
Oh, you are the lowest of the low!
And here's me, married to him with a proper marriage licence and a wedding ring on my finger. And not only that, I'm carrying his baby.
Well, now you know. I've gone and said it. So put that in your pipe and smoke it.
I can't imagine you being a rebel.
Oh, yeah. If Mum and Dad say go right, she'd go left.
Because they were too strict.
She cut her hair.
Really short and spiky with bright red bits. Dad freaked.
She stayed out late and got me to cover for her.
They didn't like my friends, they didn't like the boys I went out with.
Particularly the ones I introduced you to.
That wasn't your fault.
Yeah, but I got the blame. Because I was supposed to be looking after you.
Who was that then?
Mate of mine from college, Raj. But they've changed, they're much more relaxed now since Hansa got married, has got the kids.
Oh, I'd love to see them.
Oh, you will. Her little girl, Rhea, she's so beautiful. She's a spit of you.
Oh.
Well, I hope I get to meet all these people at the wedding.
Which wedding's that?
Whose do you think? Ours. I thought that's why you'd been in touch.
You've got mail.
That'll be Mina.
We need to talk properly.
Yeah. Yeah, we do. So how about that dinner tonight? I'll get rid of Tom and I'll cook you the best spaghetti bolognese you've ever tasted.
You're on.
Mm. Nice to meet you, Atul.
Yeah, you too.
So now you'll be looking at 75% of the estate.
I want to see a pregnancy test.
You can have a doctor's report if you like.
Yes, I would. And why did you not mention this at the start of the meeting?
Because I knew you'd think I was making it up. I wasn't going to say anything, but you forced me to.
Do you know if your father legally adopted you?
Not that I know of. He just brought me up as his own.
To him, you were his own.
Where does this leave me?
you would have to fight for your inheritance in court. I'm sorry, Anna, but at the moment, as things stand, you're left with nothing.
Don't worry, we'll fight this all the way. We've done our best to avoid a court case, but if that's what we have to do...
Dad would want his child provided for, you know that, Sarah.
Yeah.
We'll speak later.
Right. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you
very much. Listen, you're still entitled to half of what I get, OK? I'll put that in writing. As far as Dad was concerned, you were his daughter. That's all that matters.
Whatever. I've had enough of this.
Anna, you can't just give up like that, can't I?
I just want you to know that if Claire's dismissal stands, then I'm leaving too, OK?
Fine, whatever.
That's all we bloody need.
I suggest you get down on your bended knees and beg him to stay because you're going to be too vexed down pretty soon.
You're not leaving.
I've got nothing to stay for.
Come here, you little bugger.
Jimmy!
Oh, do you know these will be the death of me? I'm never again. Come here, come here, come here.
I can see if I can sort this mess out.
Anna. What's up?
Nothing.
Come on, I know you. There's something wrong. If it's about what I said this morning, forget about it. I don't want to put any pressure on you. I'm here for you if you want me. Right?
Thanks.
The thing is, Deborah, we've just been talking to our solicitor about company law, and apparently you can't just sack someone like that. You have to give them 3 written warnings. Not if they're downright insolent. Then you've got perfect justification for instant dismissal. Oh, well, that comes down to a technicality. I mean, what does the law call justification? They might think that calling someone a home-wrecking harlot could be deemed as...
Point taken. But I want it to be issued with a written warning.
Of course. I'll see to it straight away.
You look just gorgeous.
Thank you. Smells good.
Wait till you taste it.
You've gone to a lot of trouble.
Well, I think you're worth it. And I thought we'd start the night off as we mean to continue.
Great.
Now, I've had a word with Sarah, and she told Deborah in no uncertain terms that she couldn't actually sack you like that. Evidently, Deborah's feeling pretty stupid about the whole thing. So, you have got your job back.
Fantastic.
To us?
To us.
Just so we're all singing off the same hymn sheet, everything in this house belongs to me.
Well, it's pretty straightforward as I see it.
I'm sorry, Anna, but at the moment, as things stand, you're left with nothing.
You know, there's something missing and I don't know what it is.
It's lovely.
No, I should have used fresh tomatoes.
Rick, I've got to tell you something.
Oh, God. Don't say it like that. It sounds ominous.
I don't know how to say this, but...
Ah, it's getting worse. What is it?
Raj.
Sorry? Oh, the boyfriend your brother introduced you to, yeah.
I don't want you to get upset, but he was my first real love.
It's all right. I'm not going to get jealous. He's in the past.
My parents really hated him. He was 4 years older than me. A bit of a wild child. His parents owned the off-licence. And he used to take Bacardi and cigarettes and we'd go off to the cricket pavilion and smoke and drink and...
Yes, I can imagine. You can spare me the details.
Anyway, they banned me from seeing him.
How old were you?
19. Of course, that just made me want to see him even more.
You must have been head over heels in love with him, then.
I was. So we ran away to Scotland and slept in a tent.
till my father tracked us down and took us both back home. I was grounded for about 3 months. But by the third night, I climbed out the window, jumped off the porch and ran all the way to Raj's. I remember it was raining that night and I just felt so free and so happy and I couldn't wait to see him. I ran as fast as I could to the off-license, expecting to see him. But he wasn't there. Neither was his mum or dad. Only his granddad sat in the corner. He said that the family had gone back to India. They'd left 2 days before. I just couldn't believe it. I found out that my family had given them the money to go on the condition that he stopped seeing me. About 2 months later, his family came back without Raj. I never saw him again.
You're still in love with him?
He chose money over me.
You haven't answered my question.
I don't know.
Do you want to see him again?
He didn't care enough to fight for me the way that you have. I felt betrayed by him and my family.
You were betrayed, Claire. I won't let you down.
I was a mess.
It's over now, though. We've been through so much together. I'll make you happy, I promise.
No, Rick, you don't understand.
I will cherish you for the rest of my life. All you have to do is say yes.
Rick, I can't marry you. Because Raj and I are already married.
Oh, it's just a trade brochure.
Theo was really upset when I dropped him off at my mum's.
Why's that?
I think he felt like he'd let himself down today at nursery.
Well, I hope you told him he hadn't.
No. I thought I'd let you tell him that. After you've told Anna about us.
You're just gonna have to be patient, Fiona.
Do you know what? I'm all out of patience. Now either you tell Anna and the kids, or I will.
I'm not looking for more than my fair share of this house.
I don't want to hear any more, Claudie.
50% is fine by me. I just wanted you to know.
Do you know what? The truth is, I don't give a damn. I couldn't care less. Daisy. Daisy, wake up. Get up, darling. Luca, Jake, out of bed now, please. Come with me.
Where are we going, Mum?
You'll see. Just get your dressing gowns on, please.
Oh, she's going mental up there. Of course she's dead upset. We're losing everything. Major Norlitz.
Don't want that.
It's good for you. You need to look after yourself now you're pregnant. Hey, you can't have booze.
Why not? Well, you don't really think I'm in pudding club, do you? I mean, what would I be doing with a baby at my time of life?
Oh, that's awful, Claudie. I know, I didn't mean to say it. It just popped out. Hey, don't breathe a word to them lot.
I won't. So when are you going to tell them?
Well, I don't know that I have to. Not for a bit yet, anyway.
Right. Get in the car, kids.
This is like a surprise adventure.
It's a big surprise, Luca. Together, all of us as a family.
Oh my God, Anna.
You were right all along. All that matters is you, me, and the kids. It's time to move on. Let the past go.
I've waited so long to hear those words.
I want to come to Africa with you, Tom. I want us all to be together.
Is it forever this time?
It is forever.
Tom's got a job on a game reserve in Botswana. He's asked me and Theo to go with him.
I don't understand. You mean you're getting back together?
He's been offered a job in Botswana.
She's off a flaming head!
Sarah and Anna, we're going away.
I'm not a message service.
Maybe you're forgetting I own a share of this practice now.
Right.
It's my family, Matt. I'd do anything for them.
You don't deserve her.
I'm giving up a lot here. I want to be able to trust you.
You can. I love you.
Then give me the cutters, please.
Next here on BBC One, Griff Rhys-Jones tackles the highest mountain in Britain, Ben Nevis. And over on BBC Two, the summer of British film continues with the Oscar and BAFTA-winning Billy Elliot.